What's up everyone, Momo Forex here, and I'm going to break down how I made 25k the previous week trading in the Forex market. I'm going to break down every single one of those trades right here, as I called it out on the VIP analysis channel right here. I'm going to break down everything, so stay tuned, okay? So let's keep going, guys. Like I always say, guys, whoever you are, if you are a family, friend, well-wisher, if you're a hater, a troll, an enemy, whatever you are, I love you and I appreciate you. And I'll always keep giving out top-notch, high-quality value, as always. So let's get going, guys. Let's go to the start of this week. In our previous week, let's go to the very start right here on the VIP analysis channel. July 26th, yeah, that's when the week started. But some of these trades I called out end of the previous week. So before market close, I called out a few of those trades. Like most of you guys know, guys, I'm a swing trader and a day trader, and I scalp sometimes. So mainly swing and day trading is what I do. I also scalp sometimes, all right? So let's get going. Let's get to those trades I called out before market close. Which was the first one? So let's start Euro USD. Yeah, so EU was the first one that you know, that leads on to the next week, which I made the 25k. So let's start with EU, Euro USD. And another thing, guys, I called out 50% of these trades on my free Telegram channel as well. I call this out for free on my free Telegram channel, 50% of these trades as well for you guys. I don't always do that, but this week I chose to, you know, give you guys like a lot more value. So I gave you guys 50% of what I called from the VIP, but I call out everything on the VIP channel, every single one of these trades, every single analysis I take, trade, everything is called out there. But I was very generous that week and I gave you guys lots of value. So I hope you guys enjoyed and I hope you guys smacked it like I smacked it as well. So let's get going. Euro USD. All right. So this was a trade I took long, as you can see, called it out, 1-4 risk reward with a 2% risk. So that is aiming for 8% and risking just 2%. 1-4 risk reward, 2% win. So aiming for 8%, risking 2%, absolutely amazing. That doesn't always happen, but when you're trading, always minimize risk and always try and maximize profits. The lowest, at the very least risk reward ratio I would recommend is 1-1. Nothing less than 1-1 ever. You know, if you can have 1-2 and higher, better, okay? The higher the risk reward, the better, but never ever, at the very least, very, very least, 1-1. Never ever go below that, okay? The higher the risk reward, the better. If you have a 1-2, 1-3, 1-4, amazing, okay? But never go below 1-1. So let's get to the trade. So this was a trade on momentum and a break and retest on a lower time frame. So lower time frame analysis, clear break and retest of that key level. Higher time frame analysis, continuous momentum with continuous bullish engulfing candles at that key level as well. So bullish momentum engulfing candles, lower time frame, break and retest, all right? So same thing with Euro HKD as well. Bullish momentum engulfing candles, lower time frame, break and retest, all right? 1-2 risk reward on Euro HKD, 1% risk. So what is this? 2% winner. You're aiming to win 2%, you're just risking 1%. This right here, you're aiming to win 8%, risking just 2%, all right? Very straightforward, very simple. So USD HUF, 1-3 risk reward, 1% risk, so 3% winner, all right? USD KK, 1% risk, 1-3 risk reward, so 3% winner on that as well, all right? Excuse me. All right, so let's keep going. Oh, I call out this trade as well before market close. This trade I took on a loss, okay? So SPX 500, I closed halfway to the stop loss. And why did I close halfway to the stop loss? Big value for you guys right now. When you're trading and the level gets broken on the opposite side, okay, level is broken on the opposite side, which is against you, heading towards your stop loss, you should close, or I would advise to close before it gets to your stop loss, if the levels gets broken, or market structure changes before it gets to the stop loss. And what do I mean by market structure? That series of higher highs and lower highs, or lower lows and lower highs, if it changes, okay, and it's going against you, close it before it gets to your stop loss, right? Like this trade right here, market structure got broken and the level got broken. Okay, I was going long and, you know, it went down, level got broken, so I closed it halfway to the stop loss. All right, so remember that, guys. Good value right there. Remember that. So Euro SGD right here, called this out as well before market closed. This trade also led to the next week, which I, you know, closed everything and got 25K. We'll get to all of that. So same analysis here, higher time frame bullish momentum, lower time frame break and retest. Very straightforward, very simple. You guys know how me and Nick trade. Very straightforward, very simple. Break and retest at a key level, you know, with steady and strong rejection. I also trade engulfing bar and also divergence as well, okay? But price action side, we, you know, almost trade the same. Almost every single thing is the same, the analysis and everything, right? So this channel is just absolutely amazing. The value we give is just nuts. You have analysis from two pro traders who trade, like, you know, virtually the same on price action, giving you guys top-notch consistent value nonstop. It's just amazing. So let's get to it, guys. July 26th, as the market opened, Euro HKD was almost at take profit, so I closed most of my positions right here, near to the take profits, just a few pips away. Closed it out right here, most of those positions, so absolutely amazing on that. Had a few positions still running on Euro HKD, closed most of them though, absolutely amazing. So let's keep going. So I was still up 22K, even after I closed those positions, still up 22K. It's amazing, because I had everything else just open and running, okay? And if you look at this right here, you see some of these trades are from previous weeks, okay? Like I said, I'm a swing trader mainly, and also a day trader. So there's some positions that hold extended period of time compared to other positions I could hold for a few days, all right? So you may see trades from, you know, other previous weeks or the previous week open as well on my MT4. So let's keep going. USD HUF right here, almost at the take profit as well, just a few pips, so close most of these as well, and slapped it and took the bag. So I was already up 4.6k, just closing most of my Euro HKD and USD HUF positions, just some of them, or is already up 4.6k. Oh man, it's lit. Look at this back to back, like Jordan 697. Oh, smacked it just on a Sunday, and I'm not done yet. We are not done on that Sunday. So USDKK, it was already over 50% in profit. So what did I advise? I advised to move the stop loss a bit above the entry and let's keep eating, okay? So good value again for you guys. This trade was already above 50% in profit. So what I did was I moved my stop loss closer to the entry to minimize risk. So let's say I was risking, let's say like 1% or 2%, whatever it was, you move the stop loss, let's say 50 from, like, you have your stop loss here, you have your entry here, and you move your stop loss like 50% or even lower towards your entry, you are risking half or even less or more than half or less than half, whatever it is, of what you were initially risking, okay? So you've been minimizing risk some more while your trade keeps running into profit, right? So a good tip for you guys over there. Let's keep going. We kept eating this right here, USDKK, absolutely amazing. Advised some more take profit, adjustments on Euro USD. Same thing with USDKK, to be more specific right here. This is AJ, we called out, me and Nick both shared analysis on this, absolutely amazing, clear break and retest of the key level. AJ consolidated for that entire week. I think Nick closed at break even after the long, long extended consolidation. I still held because, market structure was still overall sustained, but, you know, closing it was a very, very safe and smart decision that Nick called very, very safe and smart. But I still held because, you know, I was overall up like 25K and market, you know, market structure was still overall maintained. So I still held, and I'll further go into the analysis later on and how price reacted on Friday on AJ, which was actually good. Price reacted good and it actually shot into profit. And I'll go over that analysis later on as we keep moving through the currency pair. So EU almost said take profit, took some profits right here at the 1 to 2.5 risk reward area. Same thing with USD, DKK, around the 1 to 2 risk reward area, took some profits there as well. So just on Sunday, this is still July 26th, guys, July 26th, just on Sunday, I was up 11.8K, absolutely smacking it, just on that Sunday, already up 11.8K, amazing. So this other trade, Euro SGD, still rocking into profit, called out some, you know, take profit specifications as well on that. AJ still holding that right there, called it out. Call out some more, you know, motivational messages here, and also some more advice to, you know, control risk and adjust and all that other stuff as well on the analysis channel. Like I said, guys, we share so much value on this channel. It's amazing. Just nonstop value over and over and over. Okay. So on these other trades, I called out to specify the take profits on EU and USDKK. They both slapped the take profit along with the other trades that I closed most of those positions. So I was already up 15K on just the second day of that trading week. All right, this is absolutely nuts. So July 27, I was already up 15K and still had overall open positions of 17K. Like I said, swing and day trader, so I still have some in confluence, I mean, or in addition to the trades I called, I still had other trades open. So total of all those trades, equity was still very, very high. All right, so this is a trade I called out as well, GU. This hit the stop loss. Okay, this was at about 1.5% risk, but it hit the stop loss, and I also took profits when it came to the take profit. So this, I mean, came to the came below the entry point. So this came below the entry point, and I took some profits right here, but it later on went up and hit the take profit. Sadly, it happens, guys. You are not going to win every single trade, right? You have to know that as a trader, you can't win every single trade. That's why you have to practice proper risk management, and you have to be consistent with it. Proper risk management and consistency, all right? Very straightforward, very simple. Just keep doing that, and hopefully, potentially, you will become a profitable trader, all right? So, Euro USD, Euro HKD, USD KK, USD HUF all hit take profit. Look at this, every single one of them hit take profit. All four back to back to back smacked, all right? It's just amazing, it's just amazing. USD, Euro SGD right here, call out some more advice on how to adjust with the trade. As you can see, we entered around here, and I advised to move the stop loss to here, right, to minimize risk some more. Like I said earlier, moving the stop loss closer to entry to minimize risk even some more, while your trade keeps soaring into profit, right? So this is CAD CHF. We called out analysis on this. Me and Nick called out nice analysis on this on CAD CHF. Clear, break, and retest. I think we were both asleep when this set up, but we called out analysis right here. And if you took the trade, some clients in this channel took the trade, and it worked out absolutely amazing. CAD CHF tanked heavy. Right, but we were sleeping. Of course, we're human beings, you know, we can't be awake every single second. So we call out, you know, trade setups and analysis as well. If you're awake and took this trade, kudos to you. A lot of people took it and it worked out absolutely amazing. Clear, break and retest, steady, strong rejection at that zone, you know, simple and straightforward. Call out some more analysis, just not so value on this channel, not so value over and over and over. Non-stop. Look at this, you're non-stop. Like I said, GU came into profit, took a little bit of profits right here, but later on came up and hit the stop loss and kept going up. So this was a small loss, but it happens, guys. Like I said, you won't win every trade, right? So this is USD/SGD, called out clear analysis. Price was on a steady downtrend, broke this key level, looking for a retest of this zone with steady rejection. This is a trade I took as well, you know, the same previous week. So you'll see it right here as we keep scrolling down. I was up about 12K here, even though I already closed like 15K. Still up like 12K. Amazing. Called out some more analysis on GBP/HKD. More value. This is a midweek video Nick did, you know, just to, you know, break down what's going on during the week. Trades we've taken, trades we're in, future trades we're going to analyze some more. Very, very non-stop, just brilliant value. Like I said, GU woke up, hit the stop loss. You know, it happens, you know. Even though this was a loss, the day was still profitable. 2.4K still, all right? Even though I lost one trade on GU, all right? Risk management, consistency, and you're good to go, guys. This is an analysis I called out, ADNZD. Clear break retest of the key level right here. Excuse me. I went long on ADNZD right here to continue with the momentum at that key level. This shot instantly into profit. 1-3 risk reward on that. Shot instantly into profit. Amazing. Called out analysis on GBP/PLN, NZD/CHF. Some more value in the call out as well. Just amazing stuff. This is a very funny message, guys. If you read all the way here to all the way down here, this is absolutely hilarious. Nick wrote some funny. I was dying reading this, man. Like, you guys should pause the video and like read this entire thing and just crack up. Oh my god, just humor of the world. Anyways, yeah, Nick called out some fundamental analysis here as well, some fundamental stuff with news and saying what's going on, just to give you guys, you know, an update on like world events and, you know, news data. So ADNZD, like I said, call it out, soaring into profit, you know, just boosting up right here, call it out here, and it's bam, smacking into profit. So on this trade, what did I do on ADNZD? So before market, before the daily shift, like every single day, like 4 p.m. Central Time, spreads are crazy, all right? So at that time, I advised to take out the stop loss and put it back in after spreads calm down. And that's what I advised, and it worked out perfect, okay? Because if you had your stop loss, some like here, when I called out the trade, you would have most likely gotten hit. Like right here, you were most likely getting kicked out by spreads. Spreads would have kicked you out right here. But I advise, take out the stop loss. Don't put it in until spreads calm down. Few hours later, until spreads calm down, then put it back in, all right? Because in trading, like I said, you have to know how to adjust as price moves and different things happening in the market and also economic events and all, but you have to know how to adjust. You have to adjust as things keep moving up, right? So let's keep going. USGD, soaring into profit right there. Call out some more analysis right there. EURNZD entered this trade right here on a buy, shot instantly into profit. Bam, bam, bam. Whew, man. Getting sleepy. Making this video late right here. It's almost like 12 p.m. Anyways, ADNZD, almost 50% into profit. I was waiting for another sign of bullish momentum to stack right there. And they called out some more fundamental analysis right there, some more fundamental data. USD/SGD kept soaring down, so I was still waiting for it to come back and retest the zone. Later on in this video, you'll see when I call out entry right there. So this is GU right here, clear break and retest. Call that analysis right here, clear break retest with rejection. Look to go long right there. So far that week, on just July 29th, I was already up 19.9k, about 20k already up. It's trades still running. Absolutely amazing. So these are three trades I lost that week. Very low risk overall, maximum 3%. I was risking a little bit less than 3%. I advise maximum 3% total on these trades because they were reversal setups right here, all divergence, maximum 3%. These trades I closed at a loss, which is a small loss total compared to the entire win of all the other trades. So very small loss on those three trades. Like I said, guys, risk management, consistency, and profitability as you keep trading. Very straightforward, very simple. So on July 30th, I was already up $27,000. Woo! Amazing. Just saying that out loud, just woo! Just gotta make woo! Anyways, your AED NZD closed most of the profits right here after I saw price showing some bearish indication right here with this consistent rejections right here at that key level. I mean, not key level, just consistent rejections as price broke this other high. Consistent rejections as price broke the other high. So I decided, hey, let me take some profits right here and move my stop loss to break even on the other positions I'm holding. All right. So let's keep going. Euro SGD soaring into profit right here. Amazing setup as well. Euro NZD. Break, retest, lower time frame, continuous bullish momentum at the key level. So I entered this trade, short instantly into profit, called out some more analysis on GBP SCK. As you can see, price broke the key level, coming back to retest this zone, waiting for a clear retest with strong rejection at that zone. So this is USD SGD. I called out. I also called this out on the free Telegram channel. I called it out on my free Telegram channel as well, just to give you guys some more freebies. All right, I'm going short on USD SGD, called it out, steady downtrend, clear break and retest with rejection at that zone. All right, clear like 1 to 1.5 risk reward. Amazing setup over here. This trade worked out absolutely amazing. Shot down instantly into profit. This is Nick right here. He was up about 8k on just AJ and GBP JPY. Just amazing, man. We give out so much value. This is Nick giving out some more, like, weekly recap and some more explanations of the trades that we're in and, other trades we're looking at as well. So this is USD SGD, short right down into big take profit. Look at it, guys, just right down. I closed it right here, just a few pips before take profit. Called it out. If you had your stop, if you had your take profit right here, it still smacked it and it's still going down even as we speak right now. USD SGD is still smacking down, right? It's amazing, absolutely amazing. So close USD SGD, nice win. Overall was 10K that day, 10K win that same day. Absolutely amazing. But what happened, guys? So I was up 30K that week, 30,000, all right? But with these three trades I lost, I was already down about 5K that day. So instead of 10K, I was down 5K that day and ended up the week with just 25K instead of 30K, but it's still amazing, 25K week. Like I said, guys, you won't win every single trade, but practice proper risk management, good risk-reward ratio overall, low risk, high reward, okay? No market structure, understand your strategy well, know how to adjust, and profitability, hopefully, as you keep trading, right? Very straightforward, very simple. An advice I shared here on the analysis channel, the Corona markets are back. They are back and we love the Corona markets. Me and Nick love the Corona markets. We smacked it last time Corona markets hit. We're smacking it left and right and we're smacking it right now even some more with this high volume and volatility. We love it. Setups are just amazing and we just keep smacking it over and over. And I advise trade more price action and trade less divergence, because divergence is a counter trend system. With this volume and volatility, I advise trading more with the trend than against the trend. You know, unless you have a very, very clear extreme case of a divergent setup and it's very clear, even that traded with very small risk, very low risk, all right? So some more analysis we shared, some more value, some more analysis. We're just giving out nonstop value over and over and over. All right. So like I said, AJ, Nick closed it at break even, which was a very, very smart, calculated, brilliant decision. I still kept holding, you know, because price, even though it broke this level just a little bit on lower time frame, okay, it still came back instantly, shot up instantly, even though the break was just whoop, went down and, you know, came back up. So I still held. And I was up 25K, so, you know, I can act like whatever, however I want to act, man. If you're up 25K, you can do whatever you want to do. Just joking, guys. Practice proper risk management and stay consistent. Don't ever be cocky, all right? The market will humble you if you are cocky, you know, so stay focused and stay humbled, all right? So looking for area to stack, break, retest up this level on a lower time frame. On AJ, I think Nick also analyzed this as well, and he's looking for the same thing. Like I said, we trade so similar, guys. Price action, we trade so similar. That's why on this channel, we just give so much consistent value. It's just amazing, just nonstop value. We're just doing amazing. And it's amazing. So I still call out a lot of setups right here on the free Telegram, give you guys some good freebies with everything right here. It's on the Level Suffix trading channel. 25K in a week. Amazing. Love you guys. I appreciate you, and I appreciate you guys watching this video, and I hope you guys liked it. You know, and I'll see you guys on the next coming videos. We're just giving you guys more value. So everything is on the description below. If you want to know more about this channel, my free channel, you know, my course website, whatever you want to know. And you guys have fun. Peace, love, blessings. Enjoy life. Peace.